I'm so sorry.
And so I want to bring up
Grammy nominated phenomenal actress. She played Faith Evans in the movie Notorious. I want her to come up here and bring us most definitely Broadway and let her come and sing her rendition. Because we can't bring that child back. And I can't bring back my folks who I saw in New Orleans, but I can organize and mobilize with you for the next generation. The next generation. Can Megan say that the sun has come? Anthony Smith, somebody make some noise.
With you guys, there's nothing more important than what we're doing. This movement, it's nothing that matters more, because not only is it killing us now, but it's also killing our future. PG&E, the signs and everything you're doing, that's pretty, but don't front. You are behind the scenes opposing it.
Yep.
PG&E, either come out and say, yeah, we're opposing it, or do the right thing and come on the right side of things. We need to use the sun. PG&E needs to use the sun. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's alright. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here. But here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's all right.
Yeah!
Little darling, it seems like years since it's been clear. But here comes the sun. Little darling, here comes the sun. And I say, it's alright. The sun. Here it comes, sun, here it comes, sun, here it comes.
I didn't have to expect you to just get teary. I'm trying to keep you from crying here, buddy, because you just get teared up, and that's amazing. But hashtag don't block the sun. Y'all got that?
Yeah.
But I appreciate you. Next up, the co-founder of The Green, the church, at Green for All, one of our good partners of our caucus, make some noise for Reverend Ambrose Taylor. This is no time to play, to dream, to drift. We have hard work to do and loads to lift. Shun not the struggle. The struggle, I tell you, is the gift. Be strong. My name is Ambrose Carroll. I bring you greetings from Green for All and the Green the Church campaign. Green for All was founded in order to make sure that everybody on the globe takes part in the environmental movement. And I think it is fantastic. I want you all to help me. I'll feel more at home. When I say Green for All, I want you all to say All for Green. Green for All.
All for Green.
Green for All.
All for Green.
Green for All.
All for Green.
All right, now put your hands together and somebody say it.
Yeah. Woo!
Listen, we've been working looking at Green Broadway.
I'm almost teared up. I didn't actually expect you to just get teary. You was, I'm trying to keep you from crying here, brother, because you get teared up, and that, because he just, that's amazing. But hashtag don't block the sun. Y'all got that?
Yeah.
But I appreciate you. Next up, the co-founder of The Green, the church, at Green for All, one of our good partners in our caucus, make some noise for Reverend Ambrose Taylor.
This is no time to play, to dream the drift. We have hard work to do and loads to lift. Shun not the struggle. The struggle, I tell you, is the gift. Be strong. My name is Ambrose Carroll. I bring you greetings from Green for All and the Green the Church campaign. Green for All was founded in order to make sure that everybody on the globe takes part in the environmental movement. And I think it is fantastic. I want you all to help me. I'll feel more at home. When I say Green for All, I want you all to say All for Green. Green for All?
All for Green.
Green for All?
All for Green.
Green for All?
All for Green.
All right, now put your hands together and somebody say it.
Yeah.
Listen, we've been working at Green for All.
This is going to sound a little funny, so y'all got to come on and help me by the third time, right? Come on, you all ready? Come on, let's go to church.
Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun shine.
Come on, one more time.
Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun.
Come on, everybody, wave your hands.
Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun.
Let the sun shine in. Well, in the 21st century, now, our parents fought for equality in the 20th century. But in the 21st century, we are now fighting for equality and existence.
Yeah.
And so, if we were to bring Dr. King to this moment, outside PG&E, he just wouldn't say, free at last. Free at last. Thank God Almighty we're free at last. He would say to say that one day, when we transition from fossil fuels to clean energy, that we will be fossil free at last.
Yeah! Woo! Woo!
Thank God Almighty, we'll be fossil free at last.
Yes.
Your generation, my generation, the next generation, knows this. I'm speaking to you now. Today is a wonderful day. It's October 14th. I know that it's my birthday, but I know that day's not right. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. The bucket will be passing shortly. Not the show.
The solar will be passing shortly, PG&E.
We got rooftop solar. I'm invited. You know you're committed.
Noise for Cher, Sally, Hope.
Woo!
I'm the executive director of the Solutions Project, Sarah Shanley Hope, but I'm here today because I am also a mother, a PG&E customer, and a solar owner. And yes, you heard that right. I own my solar on our house in Northern California. And my family is able to access affordable and good financing and good affordable solutions. Electric vehicles, rooftop solar. And now PG&E is trying to keep other families, all of California's families, from having that same access to affordable clean energy and ownership of their rooftop solar.
Boo! Boo them!
Now for my family, It's a pretty big deal. Going to an EV, going to rooftop solar, has meant that our monthly car payments and utility bills has actually gone down in the last 2 years. What's even better is my daughter, if she goes to first grade in the Oakland Public School System, she's super proud. Her parents got to make a smart, affordable, and healthy choice for her and her community. Now, PG&E has a choice itself right now. Just last week, the state of California put an even bigger stake in the ground for affordable clean energy for all of California. Because of the work of the California Environmental Justice Alliance, $1 billion over the next 10 years is going to go to solar and affordable housing across the state. Affordable rooftop solar and even ownership for all of California's families.
PG&E wants that money.
Please. We want to own our power, and we want everyone in California, every mother, father, every resident of California to have access that they deserve.
Woo!
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Out, don't block the sun. 100% for 100% of people.
moratorium and everything for a company desperately trying to hold on to the monopoly it has to restore energy in California. PG&E is supposed to serve us, and right now it's doing the opposite. Join me in demanding that PG&E stop blocking progress and act in the interest of Californians.
Carbon tax, PG&E!
I fully intend on making the world a better place than it was when I came into it. And perhaps through my efforts and yours, we can make this world a better place for all the children to come. Thank you.
Yeah!
If we do not transition from fossil fuels to clean energy, then that next world coming behind us, our children, our grandchildren, they won't have clean air and clean water. And we would have failed. They would have won. They would have won in creating a world where it creates disaster. No water, more wildfires, more droughts. That's the world that we're on and the course we're on. And so, no crops. And so, many people say that, you know, y'all are crazy, y'all in the corner, and I know it looks sometimes hard, but man, you are professionals, you're attorneys, some of you out here have MBAs, you're doing rooftop, you're businessmen, your mothers, your fathers, you're here on this corner because you know that we've had no more recourse, and we have to put our bodies against the machine. We're at that moment. And so one of the things here I just want to tell you is this stuff. Many people will say that we're hopeless and naive for thinking that we can beat these corporations. But in 1955, many folks today were hopeless and naive for thinking that we can end segregation in this country. And Rosa Parks sat down on the bus. And in this article, I just heard Anna, it might be her, or somebody, one of you, might, there's a Rosa Parks of the climate movement right here today. You're here today because you know that we can, and we won that battle, and we can win this battle. In 1962, there were many who said that we could not end apartheid, that South Africa would not transition. And thank God that we were fought for divestment. We're fighting for divestment now. But there was a time when we could not beat and overcome that. And artists like Malik and Ethne, they didn't play Sun City, and we won that battle. So there was a Nelson Mandela. There is a Nelson Mandela here today. There are many who told me and many of us that the Keystone XL pipeline was a done deal. Come on now.
Yeah.
Woo! And naive to think that you can stop this Keystone XL pipeline. And I've been, me, my friend Bill, and many others spent many nights in jail, many of you here or all across this country, guess what? That Keystone XL pipeline is no longer a done deal. It's just done.
Yeah! Woo!
Peace signs all over, and I hope they see this because it's not a fist sign of PG&E, it's a peace sign. Look at your window, PG&E.
They're
looking out. PG&E, we're human just like you. We breathe just like you. You want jobs, PG&E? Just like you. We have children, PG&E, just like you. But what's different, PG, we're trying to save the planet, and you're trying to destroy the planet.
Yeah.
And so PG, like human beings, this is human beings, PG, we're out here as your human brothers and sisters, coming to you to say that what you're doing kind of harp and stop us from moving to a new generation of clean energy, of allowing us for rooftop and other technology, of electric vehicles, whatever we got to do. We won't stop, PG&E. We're here today. We'll be here tomorrow. We'll be here next week. Because we're not only fighting for ourselves, we are fighting
for our children and our children's children and our children's children's children. And you have no right nor authority to take away their future for your profits. The game, PG&E, ends right now.
She's very young. I can't lose another family member to asthma. We can't lose any more family members to cancer and asthma and these diseases that
That's
are coming
right.
from this pollution.
That's right. Preach!
The song that I'm about to sing was written by Marvin Gaye over 40 years ago. And you gotta listen to the words. When I sang it in Brooklyn a few weeks ago, Leonardo DiCaprio said, are those the original words for the song? Because it's so crazy. The words that he said are more, like, more real now and crazier now, worse now than when he wrote it. So pay really close attention to these words. Mercy, mercy me. Poison is the wind that blows from the north and south. Oh, mercy, mercy me. Things ain't what they used to be, no. Oil wasted on the ocean and upon our seas, fish full of mercury. Mercy me. Oh, things ain't what they used to be. Radiation underground and in the sky. Animals and birds who live nearby are dying. Oh, mercy, mercy me.
Message and we'll send it off to the PUC. So I hope you'll take that action before you go. Thanks, everyone.
Won't stop.
Let's go get him. Thank you so much.